Hi, Danny here from Danny's Do-It-Yourself Garage. In today's video, I'll show you how to test your vehicle's electrical system. I'll load test the battery and test the diodes in your alternator. I'll do this with tools you probably already own or can purchase without breaking the bank. Our first test is to do a visual inspection on the battery. Make sure the positive cable is clean and tight. There is no signs of acid leaks. Inspect the negative cable as well. Inspect the case for swelling or sulfur smell. If you find the battery's leaking or it smells like sulfur or the case is bloated, don't even go any further, replace the battery. If your battery has caps, let's remove them now with a flat screwdriver. And remember, always wear safety glasses and gloves when working around batteries. Use a flashlight to look at the acid level. You want to see the level higher than the plates. My level looks good, so I'll reinstall my caps. But if your level is low, add some distilled water to bring the level up. Next, I'll install the voltmeter. Red or positive lead goes to the positive or plus side of the battery, and the black or negative lead goes to the negative or minus side of the battery. Now let's set up our meter. We have our black lead on COM, which is the negative side, and the red lead on volts, which is the positive side. Now switch the dial to DC volts. My battery is reading 12.3 volts. 12.4 volts represents a 75% charge, and that's what's needed to properly test this system. If your battery is under 12.4 volts, you should charge your battery before continuing. I'm close enough here, so I can continue my testing. With your meter still connected to the battery, select the MinMax function on your meter. This will record the minimum reading when performing a battery load test using the starter motor, and record the highest reading when we load the charging system using the high beams and the blower motor. Now it's time to put a load on the battery. As I crank the engine, the meter will record the voltage drop. Now I'll turn on the high beams and the blower motor and raise the engine idle to 1500 RPM. Now let's shut down everything and check our meter. When I push the min-max button, this displays the highest reading. My reading is 14.5 volts. This is a pass. A reading above 15 volts needs further inspection. As I push the min-max button again, this recorded the lowest voltage as the starter was cranking the engine. This was 10.1 volts. If this were 9.6 volts or lower, this battery test would have failed. At this point, our starting and charging system has passed. Our next test is the alternator ripple test. This test will test the diodes in your alternator. Remove the positive lead from your battery and place it on the battery terminal on your alternator. This will be the largest wire that comes off your alternator. Back at the meter, change this from DC volts to AC volts. With the engine running, you should measure less than 0.5 volts for this test to pass. We are looking good here. This concludes the charging system test. Congratulations, you just saved yourself hundreds of dollars. If you're still having problems, it could be due to a parasitic draw. Watch my video, How to Test for a Parasitic Draw.